Chanel.
Chanel. Chanel.
Versal. Chanel.
Topper.
Kut, kut, kut.
Is, weet ik even niet.
Nou, een nieuw nu. Although. PM.
Sneakers van Bali. Maar
we moeten door!
Door!
Oké.
Hey guys! Welcome to a new video. I'm here today with Machtel.
Hi!
And we are gonna discuss if Chanel, Louis Vuitton and the beautiful Dior bags are worth the investment.
Okay, so let's start off with Chanel, I think, right?
Yes.
Okay, so we all know Chanel and we all know this beauty. It's the Chanel Classic Flatback in the medium size. And yeah, if it's worth the investment, well, we can tell you a little bit of history. So when Chanel first produced this bag, it was for sale for $220. So the new price today is 6,350 euros. Which is insane.
Oh my God.
So a lot of price increases have happened over the year. The latest price increase was in January this year. Chanel increased the prices with 4 to 7%. So that's, yeah, it sounds a little, but that's for a Chanel bag, that's 300 euros.
Yes.
Which is insane. But last year they rose their prices for around 20%, which is, well,
insane.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Okay, so this one, I would say definitely worth the investment. What do you think?
Yeah, for me too, definitely worth investment. I don't think you will ever lose money on this bag.
No.
And you can also use it like for everything, night out, for during the day. Yeah.
Yeah,
it's just easy to throw on, fits with every outfit. So I think it's worth investment.
I think so too, yeah. I hoped, or I said to my grandma, I really hoped you bought it like when it was $220. That was like, only imagine if you did, then you are just super lucky right now.
Yeah.
So the price for the Chanel Classic Flatback at Etoile has also increased over the past 3 years.
Yes.
So first we sold it for 2,500, and now this one is, I think, 3,300.
Ooh.
So yeah, yeah. So yeah. I would say, yeah.
Buy it today.
Buy
it after watching this video.
Yes. Please do, and just buy it in black. It's the ultimate classic.
Yes.
Okay, and then we also have the small one. I think right now. Yeah, if we have it, then it's 3,000 euros right now, and first they were, I think, 2,300 euros. So, yeah, that's this one. That's my baby. So, for Louis Vuitton, they also increased their prices. This year already, we are 2 months in this year.
They are
really early. So I would say a Neverfull is a perfect classic.
Yeah, I agree.
So the Neverfull was introduced in 2009 only as a beach bag. But everyone loved it so much that they decided to just get it in their main collection. And now the prices are increasing every year. So for Louis Vuitton, it also increases every year. Which is also insane.
And as you may know, guys, you also recognize the beach bag on Paris Hilton and Kim Kardashian. When it just came out, they were wearing it on the beach. And then, yeah, after that, well, maybe not because of them, but yeah, it got so popular. And then they kept it in their collection.
They did.
So guys, we also have this beautiful bag in Damier Ebene, and we also have it in the monogram canvas. So yeah, we have all three types of bags.
Nice. Okay, so Louis Vuitton increased the prices of the Neverfull as well early this year, and it was around 2.6 to 2.8%. So that doesn't sound a lot, but the new price of a Neverfull PM, which is the smallest size, is 1070 euros in store right now. And with us, it's, I think, 750 euros?
Yeah, around 750. Yeah. Between 700 and 750.
For the Neverfull MM, the new price is 1120 euros. And with us, it's, I think, 800? Something like that?
Yeah, also yeah. Between 800 and 850.
Yeah, something like that. And then the GM, so that's the biggest size, so that's I think twice the size of this one. Maybe three times, it's really big. It's 1170 euros. And with us it's 875 euros. So not half the price of a new one, but yeah, it's quite a good deal, yeah. I would say.
Yes.
And I think it's definitely worth the investment. Because the prices will increase every year, also with Louis Vuitton.
Well, I don't know if I think it's worth investment. I actually don't think so, because first of all, maybe it's me, but yeah, I don't like Louis. And then second, I feel like it's too much money for canvas. And I understand the investment in the brand, but I don't understand the investment in this bag. So sorry guys,
oh.
I'm more Chanel girl, but yeah, no. But I like the bag, but I don't think it's worth it.
But what do you think then of this one? The pochette. You don't like the pochette as well?
Yeah, I like it, yeah, for sure. I really like it.
It's also canvas.
Yes, but it's also a different price range.
Well, not anymore.
Well,
the new price of this bag.
Yeah, it's 550.
No, right, it's more. It's 600. They increased from 480 to 600 for this one. Okay, so yeah, 600 for a new one. How much is it with us?
With us, it's between 500 and 550.
Yeah. First, when I started working here, we sold this bed for 175 euros and no one was looking at it. No one. No one wanted it. And now, I don't know what happened, everyone wants a pochette. So, also in the vintage market, prices have gone up insanely. So, yeah. I don't think it's the best thing to say because we work at A12. I would say if you want a pochette and it's available on the Louis side, buy it on the Louis side because you get a brand new bag for 50 euros more than you can buy it with us.
Yeah.
But most of the times it's sold out, so then we are the best next option.
Yes.
So yeah, I would say definitely worth the investment.
Alright.
It's a, yeah, I think it's a classic.
It's approved for. Not approved for me.
Okay. Well. Okay. Let's move on to Dior.
Dior.
Yeah. Dior increased their prices in February, beginning of February. So that's yeah, a few weeks back. And yeah, the new prices of these two bags are insane.
Totally crazy.
I am shocked. I'm really shocked. Okay. So we only know the USD prices. So this one increased from $4,900 to $5,200, and we sell this cutie for $775, but it's without a shoulder strap.
Okay, but who cares about a shoulder strap? Like this bag is.
This bag is meant to be carried like a handbag.
Yes,
I think.
I don't know if I would like it that much if it. Has a strap.
Oh yeah,
I like it more as a handbag.
No, I like it. And then this one,
this baby. Also, the price of this bag is increased. Your saddle bag. This is a small. It's increased from $2,700 to $3,250.
That's 20%, guys. Can you even imagine?
Yes. No, I cannot imagine.
No, right.
It's happening. So.
You need to deal with it.
So, yeah. What do you think? Is it worth the investment?
I personally don't think so. No, I think it's really a hyped bag.
Yes. And then I feel like this one is more timeless than this. No, you don't think it's worth investment. Well, me neither.
No, I wouldn't pay like 3,000 euros for this bag.
No.
No, maybe if you can find
vintage,
it.
Vintage, I would.
Yeah. But like, for 500 euros or something.
Yes.
I would pay that for a saddle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah. So not worth the investment, worth the investment. Maybe. This is the best investment ever. If you are looking to buy your first designer bag, for example, which would be a vintage one, then I would say this one. Definitely.
Yeah, me too. I totally think it's worth the investment. I feel like you're never gonna lose anything with this bag, no money, you will not lose any style. Yeah, so I personally really love this. I also like that the bag is made of leather, and also that the hardware is gold plated.
So would you invest in a black purse, or do you want a special color or special edition
for your first bag?
Yeah,
I would say black.
Black?
Yeah,
but then again, I didn't.
Yours is silver.
I bought a silver one, but yeah, I would say if you buy one, black.
But for the investment,
yeah,
is it
black? Yeah,
also.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. This one will increase every year. New or vintage, you will never lose money on this one.
No.
Okay, so in conclusion, are Louis Vuitton, Chanel and Dior worth the investment? We would say yes, depending on the model of the bag you want to buy. So for a classic flat bag, we would say definitely a big yes. For a Louis Vuitton Neverfull, opinions are different.
Yes.
For the pochette accessoires, we would say go for it. For a Lady Dior, I would say definitely worth the investment, but then go for a vintage one. And for a saddlebag, for us it's a no. But if you do think differently, then just let us know in the comments why you think so. And if you think any other bag is worth the investment or have any questions about it, then just let us know as well.
Also make sure to notice is just our opinion.
Yeah.
So do your own research and check our website and compare the new and vintage prices, because this is just what we think.
Yeah. But fact, the prices will go up every year. So keep that in mind if you would say, no, I want to maybe save some money for 2 years, then you can save even more, because the prices will have increased two times.
Hey guys, so make sure to subscribe, comment down below what you think about this video, and to put on the notifications for our channel. And yeah, we hope to see you soon.
And give a big thumbs up, guys.
Yay! Okay, see you.
Bye!